Hey everyone, so for this video we are going to talk about the colors I use in my palette and also paint a limited palette portrait. So let's get started. First, let's talk a bit about the palette I'm painting this portrait with. It's made up of only four colors and they are white, yellow, red and black. So a couple of people have asked me about exactly what colors I use and you don't have to buy the exact same pigments. This palette is totally according to my preference and comfort. You can always add or subtract the colors according to your style or workflow. I call this a portrait palette because I mostly paint portraits, so it may or may not work with other subjects. The only gouache I've tried is by Winsor & Newton, so you may take this video as a review as well. So before mixing the colors to create those subtle hues for the painting, it's very important to choose the primary pigments to start with. The colors I'm painting with right now ended up pretty much randomly in my palette, as I was very limited by the choices that were available in my country. So I just bought more options than I needed to see what will work for me the best. And now that I've painted some portraits in the past couple of months, I can finally suggest a palette that is a necessity while painting. We all know in painting we need a primary blue, rare yellow, something dark like black, and a white in case of an opaque medium. Gouache changes its value, temperature and chroma. Though it's subtle, it's still visible. So aim for a value which is darker or lighter and what looks more saturated while it's still wet. For reds, I use Spectrum Red. I've also tried my usual primary red, that is alizarin crimson, but it's kind of muted cool red. As well as it's quite transparent and it's difficult to get a warm saturated pink or red, especially when it has dried. Spectrum Red, though it's on a warmer side, it replaces alizarin crimson very well. And it's opaque enough so I don't have to use a lot of it. And it retains the warmth when it's completely dried. For my yellows, I have tried Spectrum Yellow and Primary Yellow. And I love the Spectrum Yellow as it gives natural oranges when mixed with the reds and it's very opaque. I didn't like the Primary Yellow as it has a bit greenish undertone to it. It's very subtle but it dulls the paint when mixed with reds. Also, I have to use twice the amount I would with Spectrum Yellow to get the same intensity of the tint. I know we can always use Cadmium Red and Yellow for the brightest well-tinted colors, but I prefer not to as they are toxic and I prefer to stay away. For blue, Cobalt Blue works well in the place of Ultramarine Blue. I also have Prussian Blue in my palette, but I hardly use it. For white, I use Permanent White. It's quite opaque. I liked it and I'm going to keep buying it. For black, some people don't prefer to have a solid black on their palette. I've tried mixing my black but it's just not dark enough, so I use Ivory Black instead. And if you're feeling fancy, you can also add these. The first one is Brilliant Violet. I love to use it in my accent colors and subtle hue shifts. Second is Burnt Umber, but I use it very scantily. I remember relying heavily on it while painting with oils and acrylics, but with gouache, it's just sitting there. So to conclude, the paints you need are Titanium White, Spectrum Yellow, Spectrum Red, Cobalt Blue, Brilliant Violet, Burnt Umber, Prussian Blue and Ivory Black. For the people who don't want these many paints and just want to give it a shot, you may take Burnt Umber and Prussian Blue out and even Brilliant Violet if you want to keep it simple and limited. I hope this video was of any help to you. If you have any other questions related to art or gouache, you can comment them down below or DM it on my Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next one. Thank you.